Hello, welcome back everyone to the quarterfinals of 2015 Assembly Winter. I am Ekop, this is Ignite, and this is...
Chucky, I'm back.
Hello, Chucky. I guess we couldn't find any better commentator than Chucky for today. At least he was gracious enough to join us here at the casting desk. So we're going to have a really good event for you right now. The quarterfinals are starting right now. We're going to have Savjz versus Gaara, and this is a really exciting match. What do you think of this matchup?
So they almost have like the exact same classes. They both have mage, they both have warrior. Gaara brought rogue, which I find really interesting. Savjz brought paladin, which I expected. I have no idea who's going to win. I think it's going to come down to some of like the mirror matchups and stuff. And I'm not sure of like their exact list or anything, so I have basically no knowledge.
We know that both of them banned Druid.
Oh yeah, they both banned Druid, which is
and they're both
pretty expected.
Mage.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lots of mirroring going on.
I haven't seen either player's mage, so
yeah, neither have I.
Well, I'm really excited for this match. And yeah, we're gonna tell the players to get ready. We can jump right into the game, I guess. Go, 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 my friends. All right. So, yeah, I'm really looking forward to see what's going to happen here. Who do you predict the winner?
Of the game or the match?
Of the match.
Okay. I'm going to go with Gaara. I mean, he 2-0'd his group. Savjz went 2-1, dropped a match. Doesn't mean too much now, but I don't know. I just feel like maybe, you know, Gaara's... It's been a while since he's really had a big win, so he's hungry for it for sure.
Oh, look at this. We see Savjz and his patented Echo of Medivh Mage.
Oh, baby.
Is it? We know there's a mech mage on the other side, as you can see.
Yep.
Is this Echo Mage or is this Fatigue Mage?
This looks like Fatigue.
Yeah, there's a polymorph in the Flame Strike. So.
Also, it's not the Echo of Medivh Mage that Savjz used to play a lot. But he also used to play a lot of Fatigue Mage, I guess.
Yeah, he's been experimenting with like tons of different mage decks on stream.
Yeah.
Full mulligan from him.
And Gaara just going ham with that mech mage.
So Fatigue is like extremely favored in this matchup.
Oh, you think so?
Yeah,
why especially
with this draw, like Doomsayer and Explosive Sheep are really powerful. They're hard for mages to get through. I mean, Doomsayer only really dies like Fireball, and then you're wasting a Fireball. And Explosive Sheep is just really solid. The Mech Mage is probably going to need to like draw Archmage Antonidas late game to have enough power to kind of take it all the way.
Do you think Doomsayer's... Yeah, he's dropping it right now.
Yeah, I really like this.
Yeah, me too.
It just denies everything. Yeah. Yep. There's literally no way he can bust the Doomsayer right now. So now he gets like a free turn to develop duplicate, and duplicating an Explosive Sheep is just insane.
So you see Gaara thinking about his options, but I guess he's pondering to maybe drop the scientist. He's considering just getting the secret.
I didn't actually notice the mad scientist. So another interesting thing is Gaara's probably only playing Mirror Entity, and Mirror Entity on an Explosive Sheep is
so bad.
Not very good.
He's going to go ahead and ping phase.
Everything just kind of looking in Savita's favor here. Honestly, I'd say it's probably a win for him already.
Well, it's not over yet.
Yeah. Gaara's best chance is actually just to, like, try and do a lot of damage and then finish the game with, like, two fireballs.
But even so, there's the one ice block and...
Yeah. The thing about Mill Mage is that even though you play two heal bots and an ice block, you don't really draw into them that fast compared to, like, Freeze Mage. So he's playing a really slow deck. And sometimes you just don't draw your healing by the time they kill you. But duplicating a Sludge Belcher is going to be ridiculous.
Yeah, Sludge Belcher is already annoying enough to deal with for the Mech Mage. Like, one Sludge Belcher is annoying enough to deal with. How is he ever going to deal with three Sludge Belchers?
Four even.
Yeah, he's most likely going to get the Mirror Entity here and try and copy a Sludge Belcher, but Explosive Sheep going to kind of screw that up.
Yeah, absolutely right. I mean... Savjz is not stupid enough to run a Sludge Mage into Mirror Entity. He knows that that Mech Mage probably only does run that one secret, and that's Mirror Entity.
This is actually a really interesting play, though. Like, I think the obvious play would have been Frostbolted, kill it with the Scientist, and like develop a 3-drop. But instead, Gaara's playing it really slowly, not playing into Duplicate, taking all the time in the world, which turned out to be really nice, actually.
So we see Savjz has 5 mana, hurry up to get the Mirror Entity out.
Now the Entity is down, and
he's gonna sheep, I suppose not.
Because also imagine he popped the Duplicate right there. He could have already played a turn 5 Belcher.
Yep.
This way it makes a turn 6 Belcher, for example, more awkward, I guess. Or he just waits more. I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, Gaara has pretty good plays right now, but every single one of them is answered by Explosive Sheep. Just clears any board he wants to develop.
Yeah. So he's pretty much has solutions against anything that Gaara can put against him. Against small stuff, he has the Sheeps and the Blizzard. Against big stuff, he has the Polymorph. And just in case he needs even more solutions, he still has another Cold Light Oracle to draw more cards.
Yeah, Cold Light Oracle is probably not going to come out for a really long time this game. You never want to give the aggressive deck more cards until like the very end.
How can the Mech Mage actually swing the game back in his favor? I guess the only way to do it really is Antonidas and stealth it up, right?
Yeah, that's definitely like your best out. The thing about Mech Mage is it's not a deck with a lot of swing potential. It's mostly just like, this is what I do, and I do it pretty well. And Freeze Mage generally responds to it pretty well.
Look at Gaara fighting off the Duplicate as much as possible. Like,
yeah, he's definitely playing on the Duplicate and dragging the game out. But the thing is, like,
it's not going to work out.
Oh, whoa, this is actually really strange from Savjz.
Yeah, this is weird.
I'm very surprised.
He actually snap dropped the Death Lord without probably remembering the Mirror Entity. So it's kind of
This is actually not that great for Savjz.
Yeah.
Not sure if this was intentional.
Maybe he still just forgot
Blizzard
about the
with
secret.
Double Sheep follow up if he.
Yeah, he definitely needs. Still has like a big safety net with the Blizzard and Double Sheep. But he basically turned what was a liability for Gaara into an asset by giving him a 2-8.
Is the Death Lord actually able to hurt the Death Lord that Gaara has? Is it able to hurt Savjz in some way?
If it pulls out the second Oracle, for example, that's going to be very bad.
I don't think it'll hurt him that much. I think Savjz would be happy to pull like any minion from his deck, but I think you just definitely want a Mirror Entity on the Explosive Sheep in this matchup. So he's going to duplicate the Death Lord over the Sludge Belcher. Which I like because it lets him pull out stuff, and right now he's really looking to just pull Archmage Antonidas. He even has a stealth spare part in hand.
This allows him to Spider Tank and Technician at the same time. But then again, it's going to be turn 7 for the Fatigue Mage. You don't really want to
give him that much. You definitely don't want to overextend into Flame Strike.
That's also a thing. That's also a thing to note. He's really looking for the Archmage Antonidas, and if he doesn't get it with Death Lord, he gets another minion, and this also gets closer to drawing the Antonidas.
Yep.
So the more Death Lords are going to be triggered, the closer he gets to Antonidas.
Yeah, so he gets 8 damage in. That's pretty good.
Yeah, he's also pushing through some damage here, which for the past few turns he hasn't been able to.
So he's going to refrain from using any minion.
And that's without any healing in Savitz's hand, like every point of damage he takes matters.
Yeah, it just goes for Blizzard here.
Yeah, plenty of board clear in hand for Savjz. You can extend it over a couple of turns thanks to Blizzard.
Gaara last turn actually did nothing except for Pink. So definitely respecting the AoE from Savitz's deck.
Yeah, obviously, because there's 2 Flame Strikes, and this was the Flame Strike turn.
Yep.
He didn't want to put any more minions on the board, especially since they all died to Flame Strike. Something needs tinkering.
So let's see how much he extends this turn. The thing about this board is it's threatening enough that it probably pulls an AoE out of the Fatigue Mage, so you don't really need to extend much more than this.
Do you agree with that? +1 HP on Azure Drake.
Yeah, it just makes it so he can't ping it off. Which
yeah,
is
but is he really gonna ping annoying. It? Think about it. There's so much AoE in the Fatigue Mage. There's gonna be Flame Strike. There's gonna be another Blizzard. There's gonna be a Cone of Cold, which would be also good in that spot.
Yeah, yeah, especially because that spare part signifies that. Yeah, using a spare part means that he's gonna have one less activation for the Antonidas.
Yep. This is kind of a tricky turn for Savjz. I mean, if you go completely safe with double sheep ping, you don't really get anything done, and your opponent can then just extend their full hand. So he's going with kind of more safe play, but then again, this gives Gaara more chances to pull Archmage out of his deck, which would almost end the game
on
the
spot. Yeah, if he does get that, it's going to be insane.
I think if the first Deathlord gives him Archmage, I would put it back into Gaara's favor.
Can you allow yourself to play the Blast Mage here? Is it good? No, actually, there's no mech, what am I talking about?
Yeah, you could play a mech and then play the Blast Mage. I think what you do first is you proc one of the Deathlords to see if you can pull the Archmage. Because in that case, you definitely want to cast a Fireball. All right. Above average, but I mean, anything with 4 health is still dying to AoE. And he doesn't really have a way to proc this next one unless he Blast Mages, which he's gonna do.
Going for it.
Yep. Yeah. This is really playing into the AoE. Okay,
he can't proc it.
So he got it.
That's not gonna tell us.
Hello.
All right, well, Savjz definitely dodging some low percentage bullets there, but...
And there goes the double sheep combo.
Yep.
Even clears the Neutrons, which a Flame Strike wouldn't.
Unfortunately, he can't echo these, though. Not sure that he would want to, but...
Yeah. We'll see what he gets from Deathlord. He actually gets a minion from his deck. Ooh. That's pretty strong. It actually
Wait,
took
he got his
own
and took 2 damage. Yeah,
it took 2 damage from the sheep.
That's an interesting resolution, actually.
Yeah. It's really weird. Oh, right, because it died, and then
the first one
Deathlord,
died, which was
2
damage, which
one.
Is
yeah.
enough, yeah.
Okay, makes sense.
So,
I do like Mirinity here. It feels like the best you're going to get with that card. From this point on.
Yeah, because both sheeps are
both
gone.
Both sheeps
now.
Are gone, yep. One Doomsayer is out. Not extending at all past that, though.
But the Mirror Entity doesn't really do much in the first place.
Ooh.
Even if you give him a Sludge Belcher, it doesn't really matter that much.
I'm surprised.
Yeah,
that
looks really. Sketchy,
I
perhaps,
guess now he's like really playing around Mirinity, but he's also giving his opponent 2 cards, which could end up being very
he's
relevant.
Belching, so he's not going to echo this board.
And now we get to see a 4th Deathlord resolve for Gaara.
What is it going to be this time?
He's just immediately going for it. Ooh. Worst card in the deck.
Okay, so you got up to 6 Deathlords this game.
Yeah. Maybe even more with Echo.
Yeah, and that's 2 more chances of grabbing Antonidas right on the board. And there's 8 cards left for the Mech Mage.
Dr. Boom's pretty strong here, but Savjz actually finally drew into a Flame Strike off the Cold
Light. Or Frost Nova. There you go.
Also Frost Nova.
So do you just go for... What do you prefer here?
This is definitely one of the interesting turns where there's like so many options. He might just go for an Echo here. That would actually make him overdraw, so yeah.
He's gonna,
gonna
go for an even greedier Echo. I mean,
he's going for a pretty greedy Flame Strike here.
And Echo as well, because he's building up the board.
Yeah,
like, he's gonna
can,
fill up his
You can Echo hard. This as well, but at this point, like, I think, what's he got? Like 19 points of taunt now.
Wow.
It's almost like too
Did
much.
Did you notice that? Gaara literally just pinged and passed.
Yep.
Just really afraid of that overextension.
Gaara's
Shredder,
probably
right?
really sad about not getting
Archmage.
Yeah,
but I think Shredder might have been justified, though.
He's probably around like 80% to have gotten Archmage by now, maybe even higher with four death lords plus all these draws. Like,
I still think though that Gaara kind of wasted his Archmage potential by using the second spare part and then also using the Frostbolt.
Yeah.
Because just getting two Firebolts in one turn is just so much better.
The second spare part is more relevant than the Frostbolt, I think, because if you pull it from a Deathlord, you can go spare part, Fireball, Fireball. And then you get six Fireballs, which is just insane. Like, the 36 damage, Savjz, as we know, he doesn't have any heals, so there's just no way he could heal through that.
You're gonna see an Echo and a Ping. Okay.
An Echo of Medivh, I just love that card. Can be played well in aggro decks, can be played well in control decks.
I think it's really kind of interesting that Savjz plays Golden Echoes and all other non-golden cards. Just so that, like, in these high pressure
golden
tournament
Belchers,
situations,
Golden Oracles, Golden Death Lords,
you can tell which cards you echoed. That way you know if you still have them in your deck or
not.
Yeah,
that's really smart.
Yeah. I noticed he did that in an online tournament.
You can say cards, though. Right.
Another small thing that just separates Savjz from the rest of us peasants.
Thing is, though, if you take notes, you're not really giving intel, but if you're actually using the Golden Echoes, you're giving intel to your opponent whenever you
Yeah, you definitely give intel to your opponent as well. I thought about running, like, Golden Web Spinners, but that definitely just gives information to your opponent, especially when you get something like a Haunted Creeper. They're like, oh, that didn't come from his deck, that came from his Web Spinner.
Yeah, do you agree Web Spinner should announce whenever you drop the beast?
I think it'd be nice for tournaments. Yeah. I know online, like, there are programs that people can use to see where it came from. So I think it'd be nice, you know, if...
Is there a program
just
for that?
Just for clarity. Yeah, like the Hearthstone deck tracker.
Oh, which marks the cards in hand. Yeah.
And I know quite a few people use that. So just to kind of, like, level the playing field, it'd be nice if Blizzard just implemented it like they did with Unstable Portal.
Oh, there's the Antonitis.
Yeah, it's almost
too
like
little, too late.
Yeah, geez, that's so sad.
He's not even winning by fatigue. Look at this.
I playtested the fatigue mage
fatigue
deck a bit.
Fatigue mage is beating
and against aggressive
mage
decks, you very rarely actually go to 30 cards.
Yeah,
you just eventually you choke them out so much, like so much hit points of taunt right now.
Ooh, a taunt.
28 taunt to get through. It's not gonna happen.
You can taunt the Antonitis, you can stealth the Dr. Boom. I don't know. I guess he gets two fireballs.
Yeah, it's still over.
Yeah.
Doesn't he have fireballs
left?
With
the polymorph, it's game no matter what, so.
Quick question. We haven't seen a single fireball, correct?
We did not see a fireball this game from
Does
Gaara.
He have two left, or does he not run them?
He runs them for sure.
Yeah, I think he'd definitely run it in Mech Mage. It's... So often, it's like running combo in Druid. So often, you just can cheese out games with it. Really thinking it through, seeing what he thinks the best possibility of winning is, and I think he's actually going to taunt up. Yeah, he already did taunt up the Archmage. Stealthing the 7-3, not too relevant, but.
Yeah, it's just getting the fireball in.
Yep. And the polymorph is going to end it.
Yep. And that's lethal. By beatdown.
The fatigue mage actually
death
winning
by death
lord. Yeah.
Did four deaths on board.
So, pretty expected result in this game. I think it would have been really interesting if a death lord pulled Archmage Antonitis. I'm not sure Gaara would win on the spot, but it would have been a lot closer of a game.
So, yeah. As our cameraman is doing stuff to Gaara's cam, we are going into game two, or we're going to be going into game two fairly soon.
It's got to be a warrior pick from Gaara here. No way you're picking Rogue into this.
Yeah. What else does Gaara have?
Just warrior and Rogue left.
And Druid got banned, right, for both players. All right. Yeah.
This is about the best warrior gets as well, because Paladin's good against it. So, I mean, besides the Warrior Mirror match, you kind of just want to get it out there for now. I really don't favor Gaara now, though, looking at the decks left. Like,
which one would you pick?
I'm not sure Gaara's Rogue is that great against Warrior. Usually Warrior beats up on Rogue now.
Yeah, but what about the Fatigue Mage matchup? How does he beat the Fatigue Mage matchup right now?
You definitely just take Warrior here.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe Gaara has like a special rogue deck or something that's better than I think against Fatigue
Even so,
Mage,
I think Warrior will be really prone to go to Fatigue War. And considering that, he's going to lose the Fatigue War.
Yeah, I've heard like mixed stories on the Warrior versus Fatigue Mage, and it's definitely a hard matchup to test because it takes so long to play out. And you really have to make sure both players are playing so optimally to really get good results.
Yeah, exactly.
So I've heard back and forth on which deck's better. Most rogue decks, I would think, are going to be really weak to Fatigue Mage. But
I've heard from Impact, your former teammate, that he trashed every single Fatigue Mage with his rogue deck.
Ah, interesting. Well,
that's what he claims.
This is definitely one of the situations where, like, banning a mage deck actually has like a small advantage here, where it sounds stupid to say, but you know, like, these are just situations that these